Okay, for this effect, I'm going to require two selections to be made. And also, I'm going to be needing the two red jacks. But first, sir, I'm going to need your help. Please, I'd like you to cut a small number of cards over there. About one third will be fine. Thank you. Ma'am, I'd like you to do the same. Cut a pile of cards. Now, this will be your selection, sir. Please remember it. And ma'am, please don't forget your card. It's going to be a little while before we come back to it. So please really burn it into your memory. Okay? Now, remember I said I'm going to need the red jacks. As far back as I can remember, I have always been fascinated by examples of transcendental skill, not only with playing cards, but in all areas of endeavor. I can remember, for example, as a child, I heard the story of Robin Hood and the archery contest. In that story, Robin's opponent landed an arrow in the exact center of that bullseye. So Robin aimed his arrow at the first arrow and succeeded in splitting it apart. The red jacks are going to be my target. I'm going to give it a cut. Okay. And the important thing to remember is that the jacks are together in the deck, okay? We'll give it a cut and a shuffle. And during this shuffle, I have aimed one card at the jacks, succeeding in splitting them apart. Okay? You can see that there is only one card. And sir, do you remember your card? Your card was the six of hearts, right? Great. Now, ma'am, I'd like you to please shuffle the deck. Shuffle as much or as little as you want. All right. Now, I'm going to use the red jacks to find your card. As an adult, I read about the Japanese samurai. Now, they aim at a moving target because usually their opponents were at horseback. So if I want to aim the red jacks at a moving target, it will look something like this. Oh, there we go. It's one card. And this card happened to be the nine of spades. Your selection.